Wizards of the Coast just announced that they are canceling the entire judge program. And honestly, what's replacing it seems to me more like a singles selling scam almost than a genuine replacement. Greetings, owners of fine luxury cardboard rectangles. We are here today to talk about the very odd situation going on with Magic the Gathering judges, the discontinuation of the judge program, and the new private company that's being installed in its place. Now, some of you may have heard me touch on this subject before in a video I did a few days ago when the information first got leaked. Well, we have our details now. Wizards of the Coast has come out and announced they are canceling their judge program. So let's go into why this is happening in the first place. Wizards of the Coast judge program has been around since the mid-90s. I personally was involved with it for a number of years, even had the fancy judge shirt with the Armageddon on the back, the Armageddon clock, I should say, on the back of it. I remember the days of becoming a judge way, way back in the day. And it was a volunteer thing that you did because you wanted to help out your community. I've put in a fair bit of work in building the local Magic community at the cost of my own time, basically not making any money doing it, just doing it for the love of the game. And Wizards has relied on these volunteer style people for many, many years, essentially, in my opinion, taking advantage of the player base, people who are really firmly into the game and going, hey, you know what, we're not gonna pay for judges, we're not gonna do any of this sort of thing at all. Now, they had a reward program where it was like judge rewards, and they would do special printings of particular cards. And it's funny because Wizards of the Coast says, oh, you know what, we disavow the secondary market, we don't pay attention to the secondary market. But then they would go and select cards specifically from the secondary market that had high value to be reprinted as these judge promos, and they would give them away to judges. And as far as I understand it, that actually led them to tax problems where the government was going, wait, what's all this about you printing these cards that cost you a couple dollars and like handing out like $600 worth of value in foils to these judges and whatever as a way of circumventing payment and whatever. So it started to be sort of viewed as getting paid in these foils. And so Wizards kind of pulled back on that and redesigned how they were doing it and go, okay, you know, we're not going to give all judges these special promos, we'll give some of them. And then like basically what happened was multiple people ended up suing Wizards of the Coast over the judge program. Back when like Uber was getting hit with lawsuits saying, hey, look, you know, like we're employees of you, you need to treat us like employees. The sort of same thing was going on with Wizards of the Coast. Long-term judges were coming along and saying, hey, we work for you, why don't you pay us? All this kind of thing. So you combine problems with the IRS, with problems with lawsuits, and Wizards of the Coast actually decided that they were going to just scrap the judge program. Now, originally when they decided to scrap the judge program, there was nothing put in place to replace it. So this new judge group that's been created, that's going to charge people hundreds of dollars to be a member, that was never part of the original plan for Wizards of the Coast. They just said, you know what? The judge program is a legal liability. Let's just shut it down. You know what? Let's just axe the whole thing. And that would actually fall in line with what's going on with competitive Magic, or the lack of competitive Magic. If you don't know, Wizards of the Coast used to have this grand vision where it would be like, hey, little Billy, buy yourself the booster packs, play Magic, aspire to get onto the Pro Tour, try and reach the ultimate heights of Magicdom. And they pushed this dream pretty hard. Ride the gravy train. You join the Pro Tour, you can make the money. They even used to insert Pro Tour cards into the booster packs where it's like, check out these pro players, trying to increase their profile and thus create that desire to play in the higher level events. And that's really what the judge program was for, right? You'd have people judging at local game stores, but then you'd have people judging at the Pro Tour qualifiers, you'd have people judging at the Pro Tour events, all these sort of things. Well, that's all been collapsed. Wizards of the Coast has axed all of that. The Pro Tour doesn't exist anymore. There's now just the Magic Pro League, which is a handful of selected people who have been given particular contracts to play Magic the Gathering. So all of these intermediary tournaments that used to require judges are all gone. The only official thing that really requires judges at all anymore are like the Magic Fest for Channel Fireball. And actually, I think they've reached the point where they're not even required to specifically have the like judges that have gone through a judge program anymore. Wizards of the Coast has just said, you know what? You can just run tournaments. Just make sure people have some rules knowledge. You don't actually technically need to be a judge. You don't need the certification that's coming from this program here. As far as I understand, for all the information that I've seen, and bear in mind, I do make errors sometimes. So if it turns out that I am wrong on this, then corrections will be made down in like the comment section or whatever. I'll put like a little in the description, I'll say updated information. It turns out that what I said about them not being required is wrong. But as far as I understand it, judges are no longer required. The Wizards may utilize them at their highest level events, but judges are no longer required. So now they have this new judge certification company, which is a private for-profit organization. This isn't some sort of like, they have, for different trades, plumbers, electricians, as far as I understand it, they have their own kind of organizations that are paid for by the members, made up of the members. They vote for who's in charge and everything like that. This group is just someone that Wizards has like basically had conversations with who like, yeah, you know what? Screw it. You can be in charge of this private organization, wholly owned by you, apparently, a for-profit corporation that's in charge of like you need to be like accredited, certified sort of judge. You'll be in charge. Your company will be in charge of making people these certified judges. Now, I honestly, I'm trying to remain calm in this video and not rant and rave, but the whole situation, it really frustrates me. As somebody who put a lot of effort into growing Magic in the local community out of just my own goodwill towards the game, this whole situation seems gross to me, and it feels like it borders on being a scam, really. That's what it feels like to me. Now, bear in mind, again, these are my personal opinions, but we've got a situation where in most cases, judges aren't required anymore, especially not certified judges. And now you have a judge program where if you want to be part of their program, you have to pay them. For a level one, it's $100 a year. For a level two, it's $200 a year. And for a level three, it's $400 a year. And all of these costs seem to be based on how many of these judge foils are being given out. The new system is that Wizards of the Coast will print judge foils, sell them to this private company, and this private company will then distribute these foils to each level of judges. So it really almost just seems like Wizards of the Coast prints the singles, sells them to this company, and this company goes, yeah, that's going to be your reward. Here you go. This is what you get. Like, you literally have to pay them hundreds of dollars a year to be a part of the program. And the majority of judges in Magic the Gathering are level ones. But level one is a useless level now. If you want to run big events, like if you're going to try and get Channel Fireball to hire you to work for them, they're going to want you as a level two. There may be a couple slots for some runners as level ones, but there are thousands upon thousands upon thousands of level one judges. There are over 5,000 level one judges currently, and their position is essentially useless at this point. You don't need it for LGSs. LGSs do not need a level one. Technically, they don't even need a level zero rules advisor, which is another level they're trying to be cash grabby with, where rules advisors can cost you anywhere from $0 to $50, depending. So you can be a rules advisor for free, or you can pay them $50 a month and they'll give you some branded stuff. Like, check it out, here's some judge sleeves or whatever. It honestly just seems like a massive scam. The majority of judges aren't required. On top of that, you have a private company which makes the judges clients of these of this private company, right? So how it works is level one, level two, level three, whatever you are a client of this company. You are paying your membership fees to be a part of this, your membership dues, however you want to look at it. But that makes you a client of this private for-profit corporation company. I don't know if it's a corporation. Most likely it's going to be a corporation to try and help avoid lawsuits and things like that, you know, and personal liability if somebody owned the company directly. But anyways, you've got this private company that you pay money to. Like a level two judge, for example, pays them $200. They're a client of this company. But you know what level two judges are required to do? They're required to teach level one judges for free. There's no mention of any kind of payment. Level two judges were always the ones that were meant to like mentor and test the level one judges. That's how it worked under the volunteer program before. It's not a volunteer program anymore. Now it's a company you pay money to, and as a level two judge, as a client of this company, you're expected to train the other people, the level ones, who are paying membership fees into this as well, their clients. So the clients that are paying this private company money, you're expected to train them, grade them, say whether they should pass up to the next level and pay these higher dues. And honestly, the only difference that it seems like with the dues is it determines how many foils you get. The judge foils, it seems like it's almost a bribe style setup where it's like, oh, do you want judge foils? Pay to be a part of this organization. They're in no way guaranteeing to find you work. They're in no way guaranteeing to advocate for you to try and get you increased wages. It's literally just, we're going to create a certification system where, oh, look, to be certified by us, you need to pay and meet these criteria. But the criteria for level two and level three are staying exactly the same. The level ones, they're going, oh, you know what, you're going to have to take some customer handling skill classes online kind of thing. But overall, it doesn't seem like they're changing much of the program at all, aside from going, now we want you to pay. And remember what I said before, Wizards of the Coast was going to scrap the program entirely. They were just going to dispense with it and go, we don't need it. They've already gotten rid of Pro Tour photographers. They've already gotten rid of the Pro Tour coverage, all that, like, and by, I'm saying Pro Tour, but the Pro Tour is gone. They've gotten rid of coverage for events like the Grand Prix, all that kind of stuff. The professional photographers, in terms of organized paper magic, it is collapsing in on itself. It's a black hole just sucking everything in. It's donezo. There's no more path to the top, at least not under the old way. Like, you can technically become a streamer and have Wizards pick you up and be like, okay, please join our MPL. But overall, the need for judges is gone. And they're doing more and more stuff with Arena as well, which again, completely obviates the need for judges. So I think it's kind of scuzzy to have a company where you require level one judges to pay you $100. And the only justification for these fees is like, oh, we need to set up legal protections for ourselves, and we need to pay the salaries of all the people who are working in this organization. So now that all they're like group funding through a bunch of judges who will never really reap any benefit from it, aside maybe from the foils that they're given. But with the foils being given out, like, okay, if you spend $100 a year, you're getting this number of foils, it's going to pin the value of these foils to the cards, as the value of these foils to the cards and the price that's being paid for the membership. So it's a situation where we're going to most likely see a devaluation of the judge foils as well. So that doesn't really speak to a good argument as to why you would join this program. It honestly seems like a dead-end program that's designed to just milk a bunch of money out of Magic players in this weird sort of window we're in, where Magic organized play is dwindling and shrinking and whatever. And it's a Channel Fireball is the only one with a contract to handle anything outside of Magic's massive official, like, special Mythic Invitationals or whatever. Everything else that's big is contracted out to Channel Fireball, and so that just leaves local store level, which doesn't need judges. So this program has no use, really, at the end of the day. When you look at it, Wizards of the Coast has shown that it has no use by going, they were perfectly fine with dispensing with the judge program altogether, which means that it's not needed. And they're trying to justify the value of this organization by going, we're reaching out to other games, and you're gonna be accredited judges for things like Keyforge as well. But the value is not there. In my opinion, the value is absolutely not there. And this does just seem like a gross cash grab designed to just take from people who love magic. It's like, well, if they were foolish enough to volunteer, I mean, maybe they'll pay for this. Now, there are some level 3 judges out there and level 2 judges who will go along with it because they don't want to lose their status. There was one who was grossly just, like, basically just championing this in the Discord, and I think in the judge Discord. And I think it's because for these higher level judges, some of them, they don't want to lose the status that they have from being a judge. So they don't care what it costs. As long as there's a judge organization, they don't care how much it bilks other people. They basically just go, there's no transparency with this. You don't actually get to see how this company is going to be spending the money that you give them. On top of that, apparently from the documentation that's given, what they're doing is wouldn't be legal in certain places, which is why it currently only covers 75% of existing judges. Apparently the kind of setup that they're trying to give might not actually be something they can legally do in other countries, because multiple times in the documentation talking about all this, they cite the legal concerns and why they're not in certain areas. So to me, the whole thing just seems really awful. It's just kind of Wizards going, oh, you know what, we were gonna just scrap the judge program, but if we can print these foils and sell them to you guys, and then you have a judge program that we can take advantage of and you're taking their money, what do we care? If they want to pay, fine, so be it. To me, this is just, it's just another gross thing related to Magic the Gathering. I'm very disappointed by this, honestly, and I find myself being disappointed by Magic a fair bit recently. And I know people will go, oh, why don't you just quit? If you are only going to say negative things, why don't you just quit? And it's like, somebody, talking about this stuff sometimes leads to solutions. Sometimes it does. Sometimes it doesn't. I don't know, man. At the end of the day, I'm not telling you that you have to feel like I do. I'm just disappointed. I want to enjoy myself. I want to talk about the things that I enjoy. And I honestly tried to today. I tried to record videos getting hyped about certain Magic cards. Oh, I'll talk about this. But each time I tried, each time I started like to hit the record to go and get the video going, I just couldn't stop thinking about this and what they're doing to the game. And it's just like, this is just another sign of the times, man. And it makes me feel disappointed. But anyways, I'm going to end it off because I think at this point I'll just retread what I'm saying over and over. So thanks to my Patreons, my patrons, I should say. Thanks to my channel members for supporting the channel. And remember, my friends,
together we are the sixth color of magic.